SRL class is a video production class, and it's part of PBS NewsHour.
We teach kids video journalism so that they can take those skills on to the high schools and on into careers and college majors.
Overall, what you're trying to shoot for total is an entire piece that's about 1 to 2 minutes long.
There's the technical side of things, from how to set up and operate camera systems, lighting systems, audio systems, to how to do post-production through the computers and using the Adobe suite. We also get to show them how to interact with people. They have to do the journalism side as well. They need to be able to communicate effectively and have a professional relationship with their subjects, with their peers, with their teachers, with their mentors. We get to push them quite a bit.
You must shoot all A-roll and 2 B-roll sequences with your camera and tripod. So you're gonna have an interview and at least 2 different sequences of B-roll.
The SRL class is a really interactive class that trains video journalists for the next generation of media-focused journalism, where we can uncover stories using cameras, using lights, instead of just writing down stories. It's taught me a lot of technical skills, and I love that. It partners with the PBS NewsHour, and we can create these videos, and they go on public and sometimes national news, depending on the high quality of what we've produced.
For our class, we've had Mr. Ben Garcia come over from our local affiliate and has been in the class every day, 5 days a week, Monday through Friday.
Well, you know you're gonna start with an establishing shot. In our case, it's gonna be maybe, we'll decide as a group, maybe it'll be the outside of the front of the building, because this is where it's happening. I wanna tell our audience, Hedrick Middle School is where this video is happening, right?
A high-performing student reporting lab has a station partner, like myself, going to the school and being a support to that teacher and those students.
He's also provided the professional development that I need in order to effectively teach the class. Anything from those day-to-day routines to going and training in Washington, D.C. over the summers. Working directly with the students, hands-on the equipment, showing them from more professional level.
An effective student reporting lab site needs equipment. It needs a classroom. It needs to meet 3 or more times a week. It needs to be a smaller class, 9 to 19 students. It needs support from administrators in terms of advertising, that they have this great relationship with not only local industry, but with national industry.
Your lead questions introduce your subject and something interesting about them or their interests or whatever, just general, get to know ya. And your last lead question introduces your, starts with a T, topic.
It's been surprising in some ways how quickly they were able to start shooting ideas, and the ability to get creative with that has been very good.
What I've learned in SRL is how to do videography, learn how to set up mics, set up a camera, lighting, make the interview subject comfortable when you're doing an interview. And
my favorite part of the SRL class is going out into the field and actually making interviews and actually taking videos, because I feel like everything that I've learned is actually coming to something, and I feel like I'm actually doing something with my knowledge.
My favorite part of SRL is definitely interviewing. I love going out and taking videos. I love setting up because I can frame it and adjusting all of the settings. It's really exhilarating. And asking the questions, of course. Kind of makes someone not as nervous.
What's your name? What do you do? These are lead questions. Your last lead question introduces your topic. What is an aspect of Hedrick Middle School that you're interested in? Notice he didn't get right to PE class. He introduced the topic of school.
I really just like the whole class. It's a very fun class, and I get to learn a lot about video production. I think my favorite part would be getting the people to interview, because you get to go through all these people who you want to learn about, and then you pick the best ones, and it's very cool to learn about like what they're going through. And
yeah, really digging deep into those stories. It's not necessarily the interviews themselves, it's what comes out through the people in the interviews. Well, how we can create an entire video centering around one subject, but it can change people's views. How we can have an impact in our community.
The idea of student reporting labs through the PBS NewsHour has been that students should be focusing on student-based issues, or that students are focusing on bigger issues, but through the lens of a student.
What we'd really like is to have students share with the world their point of view relating to topics and issues that affect us all. It's a showcase of students' best work on the air of the local station, on PBS NewsHour during their nightly broadcast.
So the projects the students are working on have been built around certain topics. The first topic that we looked at was how to recognize our predispositions towards others, our inherent biases towards others.
Yeah, I think people have stereotyped me a lot. They think a lot of things like that I'm a legal immigrant and that I should go back to Mexico and a lot of stuff like that when I was born here and raised here.
A false concept that people assume about me is that because I'm a girl, I can't do things that guys can do.
I wasn't raised to do it, but it's just something that you do, you know. You have to do it before you meet somebody. You can't just go up to somebody with absolutely nothing knowing about them, because like it's impossible to go up to somebody and not have something about them that you've made up in your brain.
The kind of students that student reporting labs are looking for are students that like video cameras, like journalism, are interested in the news, and they also are interested in the art of putting together video clips into a digital story that is impactful for themselves and their community. Thus, we're looking for students that are not only hard workers, that have not only shown academic success, but are ready to take that next step to show their community, their parents, their teachers, that they're ready for an industry level experience.
For those kids that come back next year, we won't have to do any foundational work. We're gonna jump right into a video assignment while the other kids are learning the fundamentals and foundation with Mr. O.
I've always kind of liked cameras and photography and all that. I think SRL isn't for everyone, but I think a lot of people would enjoy it next year.
I've always really liked doing stuff with computers and taking videos of stuff and stuff like that. And so when I heard there was a class back in elementary that taught you about these sort of stuff, I got really interested and then.
Students are learning how to become journalists. They're learning how to become field producers. They're learning how to become video production experts. And most importantly to me, they're learning how to become citizen journalists. And they are civically engaged with their school community and the immediate community surrounding their schools relating to the issues and topics that impact us all.
It's also given me a voice for myself. I can write those questions. I can dig deep into that issue. It's given me a voice personally to expose what I believe to be true.
I do think that I'll continue to use the skills I learned in the SRL class because they're valuable skills and it might help me in my future careers, which I'm not totally certain on what I want to do, but video production is always just a good thing to have in my back pocket just to know that I can do it.
The most important part for me as a teacher when working with the students in the student reporting lab is to give them the opportunity to see how media is made and how news is created and how to interpret the news and understand how bias affects what they consume.
In my experience, the most impactful part of this whole experience for students and teachers is that student reporting lab, curriculum, professionals, station mentors like myself, we're training students and teachers to be citizen journalists. Students learn hard, real-world video production skills that they can take into any job, from a TV station to a digital studio to an independent video production contractor. We see this collaboration between Southern Oregon, PBS, PBS NewsHour, and the local school districts where we have pilot sites as essential for getting kids into these amazing programs at SOU or having students right away start producing high quality content that can be impactful for their local community. Our school partners have been amazing. They've supported us in many ways, and we hope that this relationship between Southern Oregon PBS, PBS NewsHour, and schools continues through this amazing program that is Student Reporting Labs.
Thank you.